Ciao friends! In this video, I want to show you how to count the number of working days between two dates using DAX. And as an example, we start from this report that only shows year, month and sales amount. I want to produce a new measure that computes the average delivery time in days of my orders. Now, the delivery time expressed in days is simple to compute, because all what I need to do is go on the sales table, and here I have the order date and the delivery date. If I subtract the order date from the delivery date, the result of this operation is the number of days in between the two dates. So this is quite simple. I just create a new column. Let's call it delivery days, which is the delivery date minus the order date. As a result, because it subtracts two dates, it will be a date, but I can convert it to an integer, and this is the number of days between the two dates. If I want to project this to a report, I just need to build a measure that averages this value. So I create now a new measure. Let's call it average delivery days, which is just the average of the delivery days. And my report is already working. I now have a number. This number produces 8 and a half days as the average number of days. But what if I want to compute the same value but count the working days? Avoid using Saturdays, Sundays, or whatever vacation is in between these two dates. Now I can no longer just use a simple subtraction. What I need to do is search in the date table for the dates which are working days and lies in between these two dates. Again, I need to write a bit more DAX. If we take a look at the date table, I already have here a column is working day, which is either true or false. It is true in working days and it is false in non-working days. The way you populate this column is totally up to you. This version is very simple. You might need to handle vacations or whatever kind of holidays you have in your country. But the presence of the column is extremely important, because the algorithm we are going to use is to count the number of days in this table, which are working days and they happen to be in between the two dates. So I can create again a new column in the sales table, and this time it will not be the delivery days, but the delivery working days. So we start with a new column. Let's call it delivery working days. Let's go with a longer but easier to understand expression, delivery working days. How can I do that? Well, I need to count the number of rows which are in the date table, and I will apply a filter. That's why calculate becomes useful. I do a calculate and I count rows, the number of rows in the date table. Date table. Then I need to start applying filters. The first filter is that I want to restrict the date table to only the dates that happen to be between the order date and the delivery date. So I need to use dates between the date, and I want to start from the sales order date and the sales delivery date. Actually, I don't want to stop at the delivery date. I want to stop a day earlier, because dates between will include the boundaries. So I need to use delivery date minus one. If I stop the calculation at this point, the result I will obtain is exactly the same as the number of days. It's just more complex, but it will be nearly the same. What I need to do is to add a further condition. I want that day to be a working day. And because I have the information in the date table, I can say I want also the day is working day to be true. There is still one thing to do. Because I'm using calculate and I am in a row context, context transition is going to happen. And I don't want the effect of context transition. Otherwise, the filter from the order date will be applied to the date table. I don't want that to happen, so I will use all on the date in order to get rid of any effect of context transition. And besides, speed up the calculation. If I do that, the new column will contain the number of working days. You see that we have 7 delivery dates, but out of these 7, only 5 are working days. This is now my calculated column. If I want to produce that in the report, exactly as I did earlier, I need to create a new measure. Let's call it average working, the average delivery working days, which is just the average of the delivery working days in the sales table. And once I put this calculation here, you see that the delivery working days are always smaller than the average working days. It's not a complex calculation, it's pretty simple, and it already shows you the power of DAX when you use it in your reports. Enjoy DAX!